Hi guys, how's it going? Welcome to VR Essentials. We're live from Singapore, where you can get your weekly dose of VR educational entertainment as we dive into the practical uses of virtual reality. In today's episode, we're going to be talking about the Facebook's Oculus Quest and Oculus Quest 2 update version 25. By the way, if you're new to the channel, very nice to meet you, and a big welcome back to all our regular subscribers. Today's shout out goes to Steve Nose, NMR Shadow, and Mr. Surgeon. Hello, bonjour, comment ça va? So it's exciting because Facebook have been releasing a lot of new things, including the Facebook App Lab, but we'll talk about that in a separate video. So they're going to be releasing the updates starting this week for the Oculus Quest and Oculus Quest 2 version 25. Not everybody is going to have the update at the same time. Apparently, they're going to do this step by step. So let's look at the key updates in today's video. Now, undoubtedly, it's caused a lot of controversy when Facebook decided to force everybody to log into the Oculus device using a Facebook account. And we've done a number of videos about all this kind of stuff, which you could go and check out in the link description below the like button. However, what it means is it can integrate certain different functionality and technology which is developed, including, for example, Messenger. Now, even though it's well known that Messenger is optionally encrypted and it doesn't delete any of the messages from the database, and a lot of the metadata is actually shared with third-party advertisers and various different other companies, well, it is quite useful for some people in some countries who use it as part of their communication everyday tools. So what you're going to be able to do now basically is, without having to take off your headset, is you can chat with other people who are, you know, logged into Facebook or their Messenger. And then I guess you could pair, for example, a Bluetooth keyboard. And of course, the new update is you can pair also a Bluetooth mouse directly to the Oculus device. So this could make it easier. Or of course, you could perhaps use voice to text if it works, because otherwise it can be quite annoying to use controllers to text things in chat boxes. Part of Facebook's plan, and I think this is a really good plan, is the fact that they're trying to make it more multiplayer, more social. So what that's gonna mean is, when you're in Messenger, you can directly invite people, your friends, and create parties directly from there, or go into games directly together. So they made some general improvements to the Guardian and also to PassThrough. For the Guardian now, they've removed the grid and they've also made it responsive to your head movements, so you no longer need to use your controllers. For the PassThrough, they've moved it from the experiments to the general section, where basically you can double tap on the side of your Oculus Quest or Oculus Quest 2 device in order to enter PassThrough. Now, Facebook have apparently also made some updates to the user interface to make it a little bit more clean, a little bit more modern, to make it easier for people, for example, to see what friends they have in their list. Facebook have also apparently made it available for any user to access the universal menu from any app whatsoever without having to close it. So to enable this, all you have to do is go to your settings, experimental features, and universal overlay. One setting, if you're a content creator, that might be helpful to you is the ability to be able to trim the actual footage that you record in your camera roll. Now, do bear in mind that you can only trim footage that is 30 seconds or more. If you want to learn how to do that and also view all the other different updates that Facebook have released or that are releasing from this week onwards, then do head below the like button in the description, where you'll be redirected to the official page.